Welcome back from the break. My guest today is Angela Katatumba, a diva in her own right, a musician and a business lady, the managing director of Hotel Diplomat. Now, Angela, of course, now we're going to talk about your relationships. I'm not going to say a certain name, but you know, there was a time you seemed to be having a thing with a certain prominent minister. Can you tell us about that?
That question comes up in every single interview. I don't know when I'm going to touch that question. The question comes up a lot. The fact is, these are the facts.
The facts.
There's a company called Uganda Real Estate Developers. In bracket, you read. And the Honorable Minister, Henry Wanyezachi, is the chairman, and I'm the managing director. We deal in real estate, but on top of that, we are also very, very close. Very close friends. So, of course, people talk, but those are the facts on the ground. And that's, we are business partners.
So there's no smoke without fire.
But why, that's the smoke right
there. There are so many business partners we know about, and they don't just assume that they're having a relationship. Why do we think you're having a relationship with Henry Banyezachi?
No, because we are close. We used to attend, actually we still do attend meetings together. We attend, I don't know, we take our business very seriously.
Okay. You're not convincing me. Anyway, is there anybody in your life?
No, actually there's no one in my life.
Okay.
I'm single, I'm not searching.
You're not searching.
I'm just there content at the moment.
Yeah. Now, Angela, I know you. You know, you've said that I've known you from way back. Is there anything? Have you ever been in an abusive relationship? I want to spill the beans, so I'm just hoping you can tell them. Otherwise, I'm going to tell them.
Munange, I have. And, you know, it's so important. And, you know, I like that you're asking those real questions.
Yes.
Because people seem to think I come from this perfect world. They forget that I grew up, you know, following you.
Yes.
So if there's any divaness in me, blame Joy here. But the truth is, yes, I have been in an abusive relationship in the States, in Chicago. I was dating a gentleman, and we were living together, and it was serious. I thought that I would be with him forever and ever and ever and ever. But reality woke me up very fast, you know, and it was sad because I gave him my whole heart, I gave him my everything, and by then I was very naive. He was literally my first boyfriend. He was actually my first love. And I got my heart broken terribly.
What happened?
One day, I mean, we were together, and in the States, I was actually the breadwinner of the family. Which I didn't mind by then, you know, love was killing me, it was driving me. When I had money, I'd do everything, you know, as you would think in a relationship, everything is, you know, you share. But unfortunately, I got a rude awakening, you know, that maybe I thought that we were sharing and maybe he thought I was too much, you know.
Yeah, maybe he was insecure.
I think so, because a lot of times he used to put me down. For example, I grew up in a family where I'm told that I can do anything and be anything, and every time when I try to get a better job, he would say, who do you think you are in the States? You know, you're only black, you're African, you're a woman, you know, expect much lower. Who do you it was always that, somebody bringing me down. And by then I was too naive to notice that this guy was negative for me. So luckily, well, by then it wasn't luckily, by then it was a real nightmare. One day he just said, you know what, I can't do this anymore and I don't want to be with you anymore. And for me, I thought it was literally the end of the world, because he's the only person I knew in the States. I was there for by then I had been there for 6 months. I had no money because I just left my job to get a bigger one, and that was where the argument started, because I kept saying, I can leave this. I was at an Italian restaurant, I was getting about $60,000. I said, I know I can get 80, I know I can get a bigger one. So I quit that one, and he couldn't believe it, because in his mind he knew I should be getting like 20, 25. Who am I to get? But I said, but I have the papers, you know. So he had that thing of, So when I left the job, then the security kicked in, and where are we going to get money from and all that, because I was the breadwinner. And he'd said, you know what, and then again, I was too loving. Where are you? I love you. Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Here's your lunch. Me who doesn't even know how to cook, I had to learn to cook for this man. But the shock I got, the mm-hmm. rude awakening, was terrible. He just decided one day, you know what, he's done with me, and I couldn't believe it.
You fell apart.
I had no friends, nothing. So I remember calling my dad. My parents usually are the ones who are like the problem solvers in mm-hmm. everything. I remember calling my dad, and my dad said, madam, on issues of love, I suggest you get your Bible and look for a job. I said, Bible? You know, by then, I did know God. And I said, Papa, no, what you need to do is send me a ticket. Let me come back home. He's like, my friend, they don't run away from problems. You stay there. You made your bed in it. Now lay in it. You know, these are problems in life.
Yeah.
Deal with it. Stay there and handle. Mm. And I was like, but I'm alone. He's like, you can handle. And then, but he also didn't realize how bad things were.
Yes.
Like, because when you're in a relationship,
you try to cover up for the person.
You try to cover up for the person. There's the embarrassment,
yes.
the shame.
Yes.
You've left everybody
yes.
for him.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you start saying, Munang, things are this bad? The man hasn't even left me with a single cent. I was even the breadwinner. I couldn't say any of that. So I think also my dad was like, it's just a simple breakup.
Right.
So handle it. So also me, with my pride, I said, why? Where do I start? So I said, okay. I got my Bible. I'm telling you, I read Job inside out, and I just looked for a job. I didn't even have money to get the bus. I was literally that broke. I had nothing. And the man left me with nothing.
So did you beg him to stay?
More than begging.
Mm-hmm.
I was on the floor, Joy.
Mm-hmm.
No man has ever, and no man
will ever
do what to me, what that guy did to me. I was on the floor, grabbing his legs, crying, I'm begging, you can't leave me. You know what even the man said? He somehow kicked me and said, you know, come on, Angie, you look pathetic. Look at you. Are you crying because you love me or because you need me? You can't even answer that. Look at you. You know, and completely undermining, it was terrible.
It was demeaning,
it
yeah.
It was terrible. I was literally reduced to a dog. And actually, I reduced myself to a dog. I don't even blame
yes.
him because I was naive
right.
in love and I put myself in that situation, you know? And the guy left. I stayed there. That is, I thank him because that's when I lost most of my weight. I lost,
ah.
I was a size 18 and I dropped to a size 11 American, not British.
Mm-hmm.
A size 18 American. I dropped to a size 11 in 3 weeks because for 3 weeks, all I did was eat ice. Ice after ice, glass after, that was my morning, noon, everything. And that, and just going on the internet and looking for a job. That is the pain I went through. Then, like my dad said, thank God I just prayed, and that's the only time I got strength. That is the time, you know, it's good that it happened.
Yeah, yeah.
Because that's when
later
I learned
on you
to
realize,
know God.
Yes.
I learned, all of a sudden, miracles started happening. They were throwing me out of my apartment. It basically, the way things happened in a nutshell, I was supposed to be thrown out of my apartment in 1 month. I was paying $900 a month. It's me who put us there. You know, I was the breadwinner, like I'm saying. So imagine, you know, I'm the breadwinner and you leave me there without money. Him, he had his job, at least with his dad.
And of course, he had a family.
And he had a family mm-hmm. with his dad and the whole family who had to take care of him, who had to feed him, who had a roof over his head. For me, he didn't care. He left me there. Rent was due. Everything was due. I had no money. So I just, like my dad said, I just prayed. And went on the internet, looked for a job. I finally, it was just a miracle what happened. This is when I knew that Jesus, there is a Jesus.
Mm.
And this is when I knew I would never ever abandon Jesus. Because all of a sudden, just, I got a call from Minnesota. Remember I was staying in Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
A recruiter from Isaac Hayes now, the late Isaac Hayes, called and said, we love your resume. In my head I'm like, these ones are now calling for a job, but guess what, I don't even have money. Even $1 to go for the
interview.
You can't believe I ever reached that low. But then I prayed, and you can't believe it. The job was like, you know what? We love your resume. It's out of town. We are sending you an e-ticket. We are putting you up in a hotel, fully paid for, a car fully paid for, everything fully paid for, a whole month come for training for free, fully paid for. I said, chichi. So in my head, I was about to ask, but how do I get there? They said, just if you have a computer, I said, yes. Press print, the e-ticket is there.
Yes.
Just if and then we're also sending because I couldn't get to the airport. We're also sending you a car to pick you up from where you are to the airport. It's like Jesus. I'm like, my God,
what's
it's only Jesus
here?
Who knew this situation, because I would have failed to get to that job.
Right.
That's how bad things were. And miracle started happening. I went away for a month, and that's what I needed. I just needed to get out of that environment, to come back after 1 month, guess who's at my door?
That dog.
The real dog.
For that dog.
You can't, on crying tears on his face, talk about, I love you, I want you back. I don't know what I was thinking. I'm like, what? You mean this is life? You mean this is what men are about? You know, I lost confidence and faith in men. And I said, okay, so in life, clearly, it's Angie first. Because I had depended on this gentleman. The only person I realized I could depend on is God. And me. I can't depend on my family. I can't depend on... when it comes down to the wire, it's God and myself.
Mm-hmm.
And he told me that lesson. So he came back then after a few weeks.
When he came back, you accepted him?
Oh, with open arms. I was too happy. I couldn't believe it. You know, because that's what I was praying for. Because I loved him.
You were still here.
I loved him genuinely. So when he came back, and you can't believe the day he came back, is the also day they had come kick me out of my apartment. That's when I said, Jesus works miracles. That's when I said, hey, who are you kicking out of the apartment? And you know, abroad, they're not like here where you cry and they beg, then they give you the key back. Because there they have a waiting list.
Mm-hmm.
A waiting list of people who are ready to get in. You're one day late, you're out. So after I found him on the door, guess who's next? People to kick me out. Thank God. I said, hey, please wait, I have cash. I gave him cash 2 months.
Because I just been paid. Right.
Yeah, I just been
and
paid
you were
for
and you were glad that at least you still had the apartment for that.
Can you believe it?
Dog.
Mm-hmm. Can you believe it?
Mm-hmm.
So then the man came back. But the funny thing is, that betrayal was beyond me. And I didn't even realize that I felt that betrayed. Because now I started looking at him. Now he became the perfect man. Yeah, he was ready to cook, to clean, to watch rose petals, bichibichi, baba bats. Hey, now he was ready to do everything. But now in my heart, I realized that this is not the man for me. And eventually, I'm actually the one who ended it. And even up to today, he wants to get back. And I'm like, no.
Because I'm sure he keeps on checking out what you're up to.
Everything.
Mm? And he's a nobody. No. And you're now a serious somebody.
Can you believe it? And I was ready to move on the journey with him, but thank God. And now I thank God for that,
yes,
for that experience. And for me, for those ladies who want to listen and learn, it's important to know that love is love. You have to take your time. Love without Jesus, love without experience, love without, you know, like saying us, like mm-hmm. people to talk to you. Mm-hmm. It's so dangerous getting into these love things early.
Mm-hmm.
I see a lot of kids trying to get into it early. Fantastic weddings of the year. Hey, we've just met 6 months. Take it easy.